Welcome back, Mentees. Omar from Near Mint Condition with my lovely co-host,
Amanda.
And what is this segment, Amanda?
Reviews in a flash.
That's right, where we review these books spoiler-free for you guys in a flash. That was not a flash. That was a damn
snap,
Thanos
like
move.
Like Thanos.
This segment is brought to you by
Darkstar 916.
Yes. Thank you, Darkstar. So we're going to talk about Weatherman. This is Volume 1, Image Comics. Mm-hmm. It is rated M for mature.
Yes.
Sound like a damn commercial. This collects issues 1 through 6. How do I explain this without giving away spoilers? I've been debating this. The book was written
you
by...
You basically take the back of the...
That's how I used to do my book reports.
Because that's pretty much how you can, well, without spoiling anything.
Really quick, the book is done by Jody...
LeHeup.
LeHeup, thank you. Okay,
yes, so. And Nathan Fox is the artist.
Jody LeHeup is the guy that wrote Naked Bear Man. Naked Bear Man Fighter. Can't remember. I've only read the first 2 issues of that. Really liked it, but I need to finish that. This is a lot different. The tone of this is a lot different. And pretty much it takes place in Mars, right after something horrible happened on Earth. That
yes.
We are now living in the far distant future on Mars. The main character's name is?
Nathan Bright, and he is a weatherman, the number one weatherman on Mars. He is a self-assured, kind of happy-go-lucky character who, you know, has this great personality, kind of a ladies man, whatnot. And he has it all. He has this amazing girlfriend named Amanda. He has a beautiful dog named Sadie. And he's just living his life one day at a time.
That's
until...
Sounds like a soap opera.
Sounds like a soap opera.
I like the way he is like kind of like a beacon of hope and and brightness for the people. Because something... Like a bunch of people died on Earth. Like millions of people died
from
on Earth.
From a terrorist attack.
From a huge attack that he may or may not have something to do with. And I say may or may not have something to do with this terrorist attack because there are people coming after him. You can tell from the cover, he's got all these guns pointed at him while he's still trying to eat and live his go-happy life.
Yes.
But something may...
He's been accused of perhaps, you know, being a part of this terrorist attack. However, the only problem is he doesn't know why, can't remember if he actually was.
He has absolutely no clue.
Yeah, so he's kind of thrust into this adventure, thriller, heist, if you will, scenario, trying to figure out the truth.
It goes from fun, how do I describe this? It goes from really fun to chaotic to holy shit. I can't stop reading this.
Yes.
And that's the way I felt about it. And, before we give our final scores, let's talk a little bit about the artwork. You said that this was Nathan Fox?
Nathan Fox, yeah. So, Dogs of War, I think?
Yes. Okay, so he worked on Dogs of War. It is very, it's like a mix between... Like if a Disney animator from the 80s, an anime studio got together with with what's his name? The guy that did I can't believe I'm forgetting this name. Land of the Lost, not Land of the Lost, Land Before Time. Those movies.
Yes, I remember, yeah.
His studio when he broke apart from Disney, and I'm going on way too long about that.
No,
but it's like that's the best way I can describe it. It is crazy insanity, just based on the art alone. But it is so fun.
It is a very fun read. I mean, it mixes a lot of different stuff in it. It's action-packed. It's full of surprises. Every turn that you expect doesn't happen. In addition to, like you said, the artwork, I think that really helped make this what it is. It's very detailed, in my opinion, in some aspects. And there are some... And it makes you feel like, for a character like Nathan Bright, who seems to have it all, and he kind of can come off a little bit egotistical and self-assured... It really makes you feel for that character. There are some heart-wrenching moments in it as well. So that just is a testament to the writing.
Yes, I'm sorry. I forgot to mention that too before we talked about the art. How much it just hit me in the gut. Because, you know, things go happy in his life and then it is just destroyed in front of him. And it goes into chaos.
Yes, and it still has a little bit of humor sometimes.
Yeah, and he has to hold on to it. And it is chaos after chaos, but so much fun. And you're just diving in here and you're like, I want more. But really quick, back to the art. I said anime because it draws a lot from...
It reminded me that,
obviously, the swordfish is in here from Cowboy Bebop. Like, literally, the spaceship from Cowboy Bebop is in here.
Oh,
and I thought that was really cool. The only thing I found negative to say about the art is that sometimes during the fight scenes, they're really hard to follow.
I would agree with that, yeah. That's and the same thing. I felt a little confused during the fight scene.
It's very animation, very manga-ish. Actually, it reminds me a little bit of Trigun the manga, because I would get confused. Luckily, in this, though, it's translated with sound effects, so I know what's cracking and what's being punched, right? But really, that's about the only negative thing. I cannot wait for the next volume. I strongly recommend this one. Was there anything else you wanted to add
before we finish? No, I mean, I think that's it. I strongly recommend this as well. I think it was a fantastic read, and I couldn't put it down. I finished it in one sitting.
That's awesome. That's what I want to hear.
Because I could not stop reading just because of the action. You don't know where everything's going to turn. There's a lot of great themes explored, like the nature of our entertainment landscape and things of that nature, how we, you know, imbibe or our entertainment, what kind of entertainment we look for in this day and age. It talks, you know, the process of grieving and what that means for everyone. There's a lot of great themes explored in this, done so well within this first volume.
Yeah.
That makes me excited. I hope that the next volume
is just as good.
Is just as good, and yeah, the way the plot progresses doesn't let me down.
Because I was worried after that first issue it would lose steam.
Yeah.
By the way, the art is also helped by the wonderful colors of Dave Stewart, who has worked for Image for a long time and mm-hmm. done a lot of wonderful colors for them. I don't know. What would you give this? I'll let you go first.
I think I would give this a 3.5 out of 5.
Really?
Solid, yeah.
Oh, man, this gets a 4.5 out of 5
for me.
There we go. Because this is my kind of story. I want more. I cannot wait to read the second volume whenever that comes out. But holy shit, this blew me away.
It was really good.
3.5, huh? Mm-hmm. What took it down, just out of curiosity?
Well, I think so. For me, when it comes to some of the middle parts of it, without giving away any spoilers, and maybe it was the fact that it was a little hard to follow with the artwork and mm-hmm. some of the scenes, there was some characters added, some characters like just like that kind of took me away. Like, who are they? So I think that's where it was. Now, obviously, I know they'll be explained later on, but that, I think, is what took me a little bit out of the story. Even though I had to keep reading, so I was like, well, maybe I'll figure out who they are in the next section. And maybe they...
No, they don't show back up until the next book.
Exactly, they don't show back up the next book. I guess. Unless they're, like, in the very end, you know, of the trade paperback, they have a description of all the characters, too.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So I strongly recommend it.
So do I.
So 3.5, 4.5, let us know in the comments down below if you've read this, if you haven't read it, if you're willing to try it out.
Yeah.
I think it's a wonderful book, sci-fi, emotional roller coaster. Yeah, you're going to hear roller coaster a lot in this show. I can, because that's the way I talk. So, Amanda...
Sign us off?
Por favor.
All right. Thank you, everyone, for watching. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button and ring the bell for notification of more great Near Mint Condition content. Remember to follow us on all of our social media channels at Near Mint Con. And don't forget, we also have a Patreon, so if you want to support our channel, check it out in our description link. And then just remember, if it's classy and cool, it must be Near Mint.
Bye, everybody.